sustainability becomes very, very important. And since she is practicing, she's a specialist in this field, so it was apt for me to call her and she'll give you some issues on sustainability. And since next day you're going to be in the corporate sector, sustainability becomes a very important part. And rest about her, she will speak about herself. And we have, it's in between, we'll have a lecture. One hour lecture, we'll have then some 15 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes for Q&A session. So we end the lecture.
My first observation is that this is a highly gender biased class. Only a few girls I can see. Why is it so? So, what is it that interests you in sustainability? Why do you think it is important in a management class?
What is the use of business if it's not sustainable? Make a business, but we don't know how to make it sustainable.
Another 2.7 billion struggle to survive on less than $2 per day. Every year, 11 million people die, and 114 million children do not get even the basic education. And there is some data related to women that how many of them are illiterate. Health and sanitation. You can just see that how health and sanitation issues are clinging to the world. And every year, 6 million children die from malnutrition before they reach 5. More than 50% of Africans suffer from water-related diseases. So, I'll then link up this data with the solutions businesses can provide. Okay, report which was produced in 2000, and that specifically brought about the harms which we are doing to our ecosystems. It's a big report and it has recognized many ecosystems in the world, and this says that many of the world's ecosystems are in serious decline. Continuing supply of critical ecosystem services, like ecosystem is like, how do businesses benefit from ecosystems?
The resources come from the ecosystems.
Resources, raw materials, okay, they all come from the ecosystems. And continuing supply of critical ecosystem services like water purification, pollination, and climate regulation are in jeopardy. And 6 interconnected challenges are of particular concern for businesses. One is related to the water scarcity. And I hope you have heard of Sri Cement's case study related to water scarcity in Rajasthan. How many of you have you heard of Sri Cement's?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you're not aware about the ecosystem challenges it faced. Okay, so water scarcity, I'll be talking about that. And then climate change, habitat change, biodiversity loss. If you continuously harvest one particular species of fish, then that will be extinct very soon. Overexploitation of oceans. We all know that some of the islands in Sundarbans are going to be extinct. I had the privilege of going to some islands three years back. Now these islands are no more existing. And just think of the rural livelihoods. People, those who are living in the islands, even if islands exist, there is no livelihood for them. So they had to migrate. So these are the problems people may have. And then nutrient overloading, related issues of companies. So I was searching the websites of various companies. During the first year, I found their mission and visions to be different. And as the years passed by, it took me 5 years to complete my research thesis. During those 5 years, all the companies, they changed their mission and vision statements. Okay? Why? Because they incorporated sustainability into their mission and vision. Because sustainability, they say, is now the driver. I'm talking about Indian companies. American and European and Japanese companies, they did it long back in the 90s. Okay? So if you talk about Unilever, now, this is a statement I borrowed from their website, which says that by 2020 we will source 100% of our agricultural raw materials sustainably. Holcim is Ambuja Cement. Okay, they say our commitment is to continuously improve our environmental performance and provide positive contributions to our business and to society. It took years for Holcim to come up with this statement. Believe me, when there was no water around that area where they had their own plant. Okay, so they had to rejuvenate the water resources. There was no water, even the people could not survive around that area in Rajasthan. They had over exploited those water resources. And now they have this Sri Cements and Ambuja Cements case has been talked even in Harvard Business Review, where you know their practices are being discussed. Imperfect Lock, it says 25% reduction in manufacturing water use by 2015. It is not that consumer is always willing to pay more for these greener products, but customers' scenario has already changed. Customers are demanding green products. They want a fair trade label. They want an eco label in Europe and America. And even in India nowadays, this demand is rising. So that is how companies need to act. Number two is that we want to save costs. There is neck-to-neck competition in products, in the supply chains, okay? And we all want to save costs. And earlier it was considered that if you want to integrate sustainability or you want to reduce pollution, some 20 to 25 years back, companies used to think that it is always costly, okay? It involves some initial investment, but in the long run, it always pays. So one is pollution prevention. That means by minimizing the energy use or by managing your waste. There are three ways by which you do that. One is waste management, second is energy management, and third is water management. Okay. So nowadays, you know, rainwater harvesting is being practiced by many of the companies, right? So this is how, you know, companies need to act now. Second, any other response on this? Why should companies bother about sustainability? How many of you are from finance? Are you third semester students? Second year students. Okay. So you haven't
tried this. Yeah, but it's a different change. This is simplifying it. Second year, they
Okay. But how many of you are interested in finance or have taken finance electives? Oh, no takers for finance. Only? Why? Okay. In my class, if I ask, 80% of the class will be like finance. Another 80% will be about sustainability. Okay, so why should companies be bothered? You know that nowadays there's growth in green funds, okay? Even investors are changing their behavior. They want to invest in, you know, the FTSE and other indices have come up, okay? And this is how, you know, investors have changed their behavior. They want to invest in companies which are having green operations, okay? Because in the long run, their investment is going to bring more profits. And some of the initiatives which have been taken up in India, I hope you are aware. Oh, that is something very common. Yes. Related to finance, you go to BSE website, Bombay Stock Exchange. Do you hear something like sustainable or something like that? No. Are you not aware about BSE GreenX? Are you not aware about BSE GreenX? Why is it so? Because investors want to invest in companies which are green. Okay, ESG index. Investors want to invest in companies which are having a social quotient. Okay, so this is the reason, because investment is also shifting away from the non-sustainable companies. I would not rather call them non-sustainable. In the MIT Sloan Management Review, they've called these companies harvesters and non-harvesters. Harvesters are the companies who are making profit out of sustainability. And non-harvesters are the companies which are not making profit out of sustainability and are not practicing sustainability.